someone has a weakened heart, or they have congestive heart failure, or they have a congenital defect, or they have problems with blood pressure, hypertension, then that salt is going to retain fluid, and that's going to exacerbate all of those.
So it would be like the diffusion of stuff in the cells?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And then you have excessive amounts of fluid in the body as well. So if you go and you eat Chinese tonight, and it's got lots of MSG and lots of sodium, you may wake up in the morning and you're thirsty, and you go put your rings on, and rings are tight, and so it even affects us. We just don't tend to think about it because it doesn't necessarily affect us medically yet, but it can with our residents. You may see low cholesterol, low calorie, high fiber, high calorie, high protein. So it just depends on what the resident's needs are. And those would be assessed by the physician as well as the dietitian. Remember that interdisciplinary team. So you as a CNA are going to be a part of that team even when it comes to nutrition, because you're going to document how much they eat each meal. Are they tolerating foods? Are they not tolerating foods? And we're going to talk about that too. You also may see certain forms of diets. So for example, you may see a soft or a puree. If you have a resident that does not have teeth, they do not have dentures, they may be on literally a pureed diet. So it almost looks like baby food, but generally a thicker consistency. Can someone with no teeth eat regular food?
No dentures.
No dentures either.
Mashed potatoes,
food, applesauce. It does depend on what it is, and you would be surprised. And generally, a resident that's on fluid restriction is going to want fluid. They're going to be asking for something to drink. I want something to drink. I want something to drink. And you'll have to remind them, especially if they're on the dementia side, they're forgetting why they can't have fluid. They just know that they're thirsty. And just remind them that, you know, we'll give you some fluid in a little bit. You can't have that much fluid. It's hard.
What would be the causes for congestive heart failure?
Congestive heart failure, or more often than that, even would be like a dialysis patient, one that's on hemodialysis, because they may not be urinating at all. So anything that they take in stays in. And so the dialysis is what removes the excess fluid and the waste. And they'll do dialysis about.
So a lot of this would be because of for the benefit, for the
yes.
health.
It's not yes. Yeah. Very good point, Danny. So all of this is for their benefit. It's not because we're just trying to be mean, but we're actually carrying out very specific orders for
how much residents eat, whether they don't eat, whether they eat too much, whatever.
So one of the things that is really important to do is document how much a resident eats at their meal.
All of those do. For this, this, and this, it does not have a measurement on the side. How are you going to calculate how much is in these glasses? Yes, this is a graduated container. So what you're going to do is you will pour this in the container. You're going to get your measurement. And I want to point something out. You need to get your measurement on a flat surface and it needs to be eye level. Right? That makes sense, because if I just pick it up, can I tilt it a little bit and not know? And intake and output is really important for some of these residents. It can mean the difference between a dosage of a medication.